Hello friends, and welcome to another video of the series Practical Hands-on in Physics and Electronics. In this video, we will see how to determine Boltzmann constant using IV characteristics of a p-n junction diode. First, what is the Boltzmann constant? It is a physical constant relating the average kinetic energy of particles in a gas with temperature. It is equal to the ratio of R by Na. R is the universal gas constant and N is the Avogadro constant. The values are written over here. So if you put the values of R and Na in this expression, K comes out to be 1.38 into 10 raised to the power minus 23 joules per Kelvin. So next task is to evaluate IV data of the PN diode in forward biased mode. So these are the apparatus that we required. First, a power supply, milliammeter, breadboard, and a p-n junction diode. First, we have to check the diode. This we can do using a multimeter. So, N of the diode is connected to positive of the multimeter, and P terminal of the diode is connected to negative of the multimeter. Now, let's move the multimeter selector knob to the diode test position as shown. Here, multimeter is showing open circuit condition since the diode is reversed biased. If we change the polarity of the diode such that its P side is connected to the positive of the multimeter and N side to the negative terminal, then multimeter reading should be between 0.5 to about 0.7. In the present case, it shows 0.523. So this diode is working perfectly fine. A diode showing same reading in both forward and reverse directions should not be used. So now let's move towards our main circuit. Now this is the main circuit. Basically, we have a diode, milliammeter and power supply in series with each other. So let's join the circuit. The positive of the battery is connected to P of the diode. N of the diode is connected to positive of the milliammeter. The negative terminal of the milliammeter is connected to negative terminal of the power source. Now we'll switch on the power and increase the voltage in small steps. So till 0.65 volts, no significant variation in current is observed. Now we'll increase the voltage further to 0.7. You can see the current increased to about 18 milliamperes. Now beyond 0.7, we have to increase the voltage in very small steps like this. 0.71, 72, 73, 74, 75. There's no need to go beyond 0.75 volts. Since we are already getting current of about 70 milliamperes. Now the diode equation can be written as I is equals to I naught exponential of EV by eta kt minus 1. I is the current, I naught is the reverse saturation current, V is the voltage, eta is the ideality factor, K is the Boltzmann constant, E is the electronic charge, and T is the absolute temperature. So this minus sign, minus 1 sign, we are going to neglect and take natural logs on both sides of this equation. So now we'll get an equation like this, which is the equation of a straight line, y is equals to mx plus c. So this ln I is y, e by kt is m, v is our x, and ln I naught is c. So now we'll plot graph between ln I and voltage. The graph looks like this. Now we'll evaluate the slope of this curve, and in the present case it comes out to be 32. Now we'll equate this value of slope 32 to E by KT. Now we know the values of E and T, so the value of K comes out to be about 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 23 joules per Kelvin. It is slightly higher than the theoretical value. It is because high value of k is because we have put eta equals to 1. However, its value generally lies between 1 and 2 and even greater than 2 in some cases. If ideality factor deviates from 1, it means diode is not ideal and departure from the ideal characteristics is due to the generation and recombination in the depletion layer, high injection, and also due to series resistance effects. I hope this video is of some help to you. If you like this video, kindly share it with your friends, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel for future videos.